wasn't supposed to happen, right?
Right,
that was the last thing I expected.
That fiddle around, and I still got the same problem.
Welcome, guys.
Hey, Tom.
Hey, Spike. Hey, hey.
That's a Prius, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Cool.
You like how it's hauling the trailer?
They're not rated for towing anything. In the U.S.
Oh,
in
really?
In Canada, they are. The same damn car.
Oh, no shit.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that's funny.
It's bullshit.
Yeah.
All right, guys, we're here at Tom Simcoe's place, nestled at the base of these beautiful mountains in the great state of Idaho, Utah, one of those. I'm here to help him tune his brand new fuel injection system that he just put on his Rotax 912. I'm gonna be talking with the technician from Edge Performance.
Turn your video on.
That's gonna be tuning his fuel injection system from, I think, Kansas, which when you think about it, he's actually in another state messing with Tom's engine, which is kind of spooky, but also pretty cool. So we'll get into why Tom decided to go with fuel injection over his carburetor system and talk about the pros and cons of each. So let's get into it.
Be like, God, what am I gonna do with all this extra power?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, we gotta get in here.
Yep.
I think I know, I have a diagnostic cable plugged into the ECU.
I gotcha.
You should see the look on my face when I go in.
What? The elephant in the room is, as I'm looking at your new toy over there.
Oh, yeah.
But we'll talk about that later. Right now, we're gonna get the computer program hooked up and we're gonna get this on Zoom call with the technician at Performance. And then we will get to tuning and show you guys how we do that here in just a little bit. And hopefully, maybe Tom will fly off, but I don't think we will. The wind is pretty not favorable for you, right?
Not gonna happen. Here's the good thing. It's so bad that there's not even a chance, you know, decision-making process going on, you know. Wind's wrong, snow's wrong, everything's wrong. New procedure here.
Yeah.
To start this thing, I flip up one mag, the one that's on the soft start module.
Yep.
Turn on one fuel pump, one or the other.
Okay.
And it just kind of alternate back and forth, so you'll kind of wear them out equally, I guess, is the intent.
Yep.
And then that turns on more or less the ECU, the electronics box that makes everything else work. Right there to remind me to shut everything down and safety that. So that goes off, then you shut down, you do that, then the opposite. Then the master here.
Oh, that's fuel pressure.
Fuel pressure, yeah, that's a new gauge there. That's where my throttle used to be. And I ended up moving it over here, and it'll work just fine.
That's what you call an ECU?
Yeah.
Computer.
That's what they tell me.
Okay.
Open that door and Spike.
Spike, you're getting cold. Let's let you upstairs. Come on. Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to restart and let it warm up because it's not quite fully warmed up.
Yep, sounds good.
I had to move Tom's plane outside.
I mount the computer on the back there.
Oh, yeah.
I think I'm ready for a meeting ID or a personal link name.
What airplane are you flying there?
Escort cruiser.
Oh, you see me? You don't see me, huh?
I can turn your video on.
Oh, sweet.
That's ultronic.com.au.
Software, I'm guessing?
Software. We're not hooked up to the plane yet, though, right?
No, we're not.
First, we need to go in here. We have proprietary firmware that only we have through Ultronic. Otherwise, we can't hook up to our ECUs unless we rename the shortcut. Really, what it's doing is it's unlocking a wider barrel range for the ECU to correct for altitude changes. So automobiles, you know, never go that high.
Hey, Doc, we better back up. We don't have enough road to get up to 88. Roads, Where we're going, we don't need roads.
They gave us something brand new. So we call it Space Edge, like we're going to space. So it's space bar and then edge. We can hook up to our ECUs then.
Okay.
The rest we need hooked up to the airplane.
All right, we'll go outside then.
Yeah, okay. I just throw the back seat in.
Fat girls have a problem with it.
Yeah, do they?
This normally isn't here, by the way.
How many fat girls have you had in there?
Have you seen this?
I'll tell you later.
Okay. This is the forward support for my cargo tank.
Oh, okay.
So when I pull that pin, that telescopes out and out of there, and it gives you normal leg room, but we're not going to do that.
Oh, I don't care. Yeah, I'm good.
Okay, here's your deal.
Yeah. We're juggling cameras and laptops and everything, so.
You ready to start?
Okay, I just need the laptop plugged in and ECU turned on before we start.
ECU's on and laptop's plugged in.
We're using a serial converter. We got to go set up our port settings first.
Hopefully that rope doesn't break, Tom. And
yeah.
If it does, I guess we're going flying.
Maybe we should put another rope down into the snow bike, keep his wing from lifting up too.
Jonas, can you run this computer?
What do you need me to do?
I need you to click on the ports COM and LPT.
Got it.
We want the prolific serial. Go to port settings. In advanced, and then uncheck the check mark at the top. This is running on COM4, so we'll exit out of all of that now. Okay.
You got it? I feel like we're flying a computer right now. You have the controls.
Uh-oh. It maybe looks like the cable isn't quite.
It's plugged in solid here, too.
Right there, yeah.
Oh, it went for a second. Okay, Tom, I need you to pull the throttle back to full back.
It's there.
So I'm calibrating the throttle position sensor right now.
Ah, cool.
Now full throttle.
Okay.
Okay, now you can go back to idle. Okay, that looks good. So we're ready to start when you guys are.
Okay, starting up.
3,000 RPM.
Hit 5,000 or 55 with the Prince prop, right?
Static's about 5,100.
Static with the Prince prop is 5,100.
It'll wind up to 5,800.
It'll wind up to 58 when you're flying, but we can't do it static. Run up slowly, okay. And then back it off. How's your oil temperature and cylinder head?
Good, both.
They're both good. What's the temp on them?
166 on the oil, 194
is doing it. So 194. Talk. We're going to go up to 5,000, just at 5,000, and then we want to read what the EGTs are doing. Wasn't supposed to happen, right?
Right. I'm happy with where the tune is now, and what it's doing clear at the top end is is weird. I'm not sure. It could be our system, but I don't know what it could be other than the crankshaft position sensor. But I looked at it, was picking up. It was picking up fine, so I don't know. Tom, what was the problem you were fighting with the carbs?
Well, when I was taking everything apart, all the old stuff off, I discovered a loose connection on my Hackman leaner, as in one hose just about came off the fitting.
What was it actually doing while you're flying?
Oh, it would crap out at 5,000 RPM.
Oh, just like it's doing now?
Yeah, but it sounded different, a bit different.
Okay.
Yeah, but actually, oddly enough, similar, yeah.
So maybe it is something else, like you were saying, it could be a spark issue?
Replaced all the spark type stuff as a test. It didn't make any difference whatsoever. I never flew it after I noticed that loose fitting, because that's when I was yanking everything off. So that's got you baffled too, doggone. Huh.
I don't think it's a fuel injection system that's acting up. It seems like it just gets to a certain RPM there, and all of a sudden it's like you're losing spark on some cylinders.
Huh. Yeah, I put a whole different system in. I borrowed from Hal Stockman. And,
You put in the Ignitech units?
I did.
Okay.
Yep. And then I switched to the 12-volt supply while it was doing it, and it made no difference.
Okay. The stator power, we can eliminate stator power. We still have to, we got pickup coils, we got axle coils, we got wires and spark plug caps and spark plugs. I can't say that I've had it do this. When's the last time you changed out spark plugs?
Probably at this point, about 10 hours ago.
Now, were you able to get above 55 and or 5,000 and it'd smooth out?
At times. It was somewhat irregular, but it more often than not would start at 5. And then it'd just back off, because it flies fine at way below 5 with this Prince prop. I mean, I can fly it right now, you know.
Yeah.
Well, I'm actually wondering, Tom, if you could narrow it down to when the engine's loaded, like when you have more stress in the crankcase chamber and the spark has to be stronger, that's when it's failing, like a spark plug cap or a wire connection or something is just not able to push through when the engine's real loaded.
Yeah, that's the only thing. About the only thing I haven't done is replace all the spark plug wires themselves.
Or caps,
yeah.
I'd be curious, actually, to have you take it up to the where it's doing that and do a mag check.
Yeah, I've done that before, way back, and that also made no difference. But yeah, I'll try that.
While it's stumbling?
Yeah, yeah.
No,
yep.
Because that would kind of rule the coils up, although that should rule out some plugs and wires, too. Well, let me think about this a little bit, and maybe I'll reach out to some other people, too, and see if we can come to a consensus on what's going on.
Okay, and just for grins, I'm going to do one more full power brief run up here. When it was missing, I thought that was you doing it, fine-tuning something, so.
No, it wasn't, yeah.
Here we go. I can fly it like that. I have before. I still got loads of performance at way below 5,000.
It seems familiar though, Tom, though, kind of what it was doing.
Yeah. Oddly enough, yeah.
Oh man. Okay, well, that definitely gives you a direction to head.
Yeah.
Because with carburetors, you always want to be like, okay, why is it doing that? But I'm pretty confident the fuel injection system isn't causing this.
Well, that rules out quite a bit then, actually.
Yeah.
So it's not a fuel flow issue. It would be an air issue, you think?
Well, the wideband is showing me perfect mixture readings, and your EGTs are showing where they need to be. So I'm not thinking it's fuel or air at all. I think we've got the emission issue.
Gotcha.
So yeah, I think it's combustion chamber pressures that are all of a sudden the spark can't overcome. As the crankcase pressure increases, it takes more voltage to get a spark to go through the air.
Huh. Okay.
It was real consistent. It came out of nowhere, and then it's been utterly consistent.
Good brainstorm. I'll be in touch, Tom.
Okay. Sounds good. Thanks, Mike.
All right. Thanks, Mike.
Wow. That was the last thing I expected, right?
That fiddle around, and I still got the same damn problem.
So just to tell you guys, Tom had an issue. Exact same thing that's happening. That's the whole reason why he actually said, screw the carbs, I'm going to fuel injection.
Yep.
And now it's doing exactly the same thing that was happening with the carbs.
Brakes up at 5,000 RPM.
One way of looking at it,
my missing issue has nothing to do with the fuel injection, apparently, because Mike said everything looked good.
It's worth trying a different prop, a Luga or a different one, that loads it at a higher RPM.
Yeah.
You got it?
Just get a little running start at it.
Are you going? Wait. Oh, whoa, whoa.
So I can open the door.
Scared the shit out of me.
No. I thought you said, screw it. I'm just pushing it off.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not quite there yet.
Yeah. I think you have the most technical airstrip to hanger.
Transition.
I mean, literally, it is a direct straight down. Right out of the hangar. That's pretty wild.
In certain snow conditions, if you come to a complete stop, you can't get going again, even at full throttle.
So, there's no go around here.
My other trip was steeper.
Was it really?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, wow. Yeah. All right, we'll see you guys on the next video. Leave a comment below, let Tom know what it could be. How tricked is that? That's pretty cool.
$50.
$50.
Here's the other.